This is Mohammad Ali. Today I'm going to present Microsoft Azure webinar. Before start, let me introduce about myself. So far, I'm having 11 years of experience in IT infra. I certified Microsoft Azure, IDEAL version 3, and Microsoft Certified Trainer. So these are my certification. So my expectation in Windows Servers, VMware, Backup, and Azure Office 365. Also, I having experience in .NET application hosting and database basic level support. Okay. So what is Azure Certificate Roadmap? Actually, fundamental is basic for all. Okay, then you can choose your career like infra. You have to go for AZ 104. If you're going to a developer, you have to choose AZ 204. These are the current certification. So what is AZ 900? So this course will be provide fundamental knowledge like Azure, what is Azure Cloud Services, and it's explain about Azure Core Services and pricing and the support model. So this would be useful for students. And with an IT background, we'll find the basic concept easier to understand. Whoever don't have experience or knowledge also, this would be very basic for them. So who can attend this course? So this is for students and freshers who is looking for job especially. And so developers and testers and project management, so they also they can learn for this basic course. This would be useful for them, for developers or test and projects, so because they also they should work in Azure, so they must have some knowledge. So they have to choose for this basic course. What is AZ 104? So this is the most of the people trying to do AZ 104, because AZ 104 only providing the end-to-end services like implementing the servers and managing the servers and monitoring the Azure resources and storage, compute units and virtual networks, and how to provision, how to size them, how to monitor them, and how to adjust the resources. So this is currently everybody doing this course AZ 104. So who can attend this course? This course mainly for system admins and who is looking for the career growth and also project management, because project management is like they have to now the course is called a DevOps, right? So they must learn about this Azure 104 as well. Then this would be useful for DevOps also. Okay, clear? So traditionally, how we manage servers? So we manage in on-premise or private cloud. Okay, we host service and we deliver the service over the internet, like web application. And but we use the service in our on-premise data centers. Now the technology become cloud. So infra as a service, platform as a service, software as a service. So what provide infra as a service? So you can see the green highlighted, these are for managed by cloud provider, and blue, these are provided by cloud service provider. Sorry, green, this is managed by yourself, and blue, this compute, networking, storage. So these are provided by service provider by cloud service provider. This is basic, this is a general topic for shared service responsibility, not only for AWS, not only for Azure. This is for AWS and Oracle, Google. So these are the shared responsibility for all cloud products. So infrastructure service, whatever service you implement, whatever services you are deploying the on-premise, you can choose for infrastructure service in cloud, but they'll provide compute, networking, storage. You have to choose which machine OS and what are the application going to use and how to access data. So these managed by yourself. Platform as a service, so you don't worry about OS and and server patch management, antivirus management. So these will be taken care of by platform as a service when you're going for platform as a service. Software as a service, everything taken care of by cloud service provider vendor. You to just use data and access. So what are the examples here? Infrastructure service means you can take remote and you're accessing and everything doing over the internet. Platform as a service, you should not worry about the OS, right? You just go and create an application, you can host and you can use it yourself. But here you don't want to manage your OS and the patch management. So this is there is no infra maintenance over there. Software as a service, like Google providing the Google Gmail and Office is provided O365 email. These are the software as a service. So what we will learn in this AZ 104, we will learn about infra as a service and the platform as a service. Okay. So what is cloud computing? So it provides a compute, networking, storage, analytics. So you have to create the servers like computer, you have to make the networking, you have to connect them, you have to use deploy the storage. Okay, and analytics. So these can be provided by cloud service provider through the internet, delivered by internet. This is called cloud computing. So why people choose for cloud? Basically, it's for capex and opex. Capex mean capital expenditure and opex mean operational expenditure. So when you're going for a high availability, so fault tolerance required, so this is taking by cloud. And the scalability, whenever you want to decrease or increase, you want to resize, so you can use. And global reach, traditionally you have to choose data center where your customers are available, you have to choose everything. But cloud, you can start the data, you can start the services in a single click. Then agility, so predict cost consideration. So we can consider if I'm going to use 1 week or 2 week, so we can predict your cost upfront. This cannot be done over the traditional data center. Then disaster recovery, so when there is a downtime. Disaster recovery and high availability both are a different technology. Actually, high availability mean when the service going down, you have to use always another node, like you have primary, secondary. But disaster recovery mean the entire data center, entire region going to be down mean you can use it with minimum downtime to start the services. So we will deeply learn about in class. Then so Azure, it's made up of around 140 data centers around the global. Okay, so these are the currently Azure provided data centers. You can see India, there is South India, Central India and West India. South India, Chennai, Central India, Pune, West India, Bombay. So these are the data centers available. So if you're going to AWS, so you will get only one data center. This is the main advantage, because Microsoft having the lot of data centers compared with other cloud providers. In availability zone. So what availability zone provides? For example, in India, so you have a services in cloud. So if the one data center goes down, so initially we will have a primary data center in office, and second data center we'll have some external party, or we will make some data center externally. So Azure provides the availability zone in single click. You can just choose data center 1 and data center 2. When the service going down, this traffic will be accessible from availability zone 2. So this is the main advantage in availability zone. So a service always up and running. We can say why you want to choose availability zone. These are very costly. See, like a Flipkart and Amazon, if they lost 1 minute of downtime, they will lose much business. That's why we're using the availability zone, availability sets. So how to call a service in Azure? So we have to call them as resources. So even if you're choosing the virtual machine, you have to call as resource, storage account resource, virtual network resource. Everything you have to call as resource. So each resource having each resource group, so to manage by resource group. So benefits of Azure Cloud. So why we are choosing Azure Cloud? Because see, Azure having a 140 availability zones in around the globe. So till now nobody having this much of data centers in Azure Cloud service provider. Even AWS having till date is 60 plus availability zones only. And fully scalable computing platform offers open access across multiple languages like .NET, PHP, everything. You can do it in very easy format. And there is a main protocol here, Azure Active Directory, which is mainly used to sync with your on-prem to Azure AD. Because after start to work from home, so we started working at home. So the most of the people work from home. So when the new people joining or we are going to use Office 365. That time we should not use this different credential, different login IDs. So we can able to sync our on-prem AD to our Azure. So this is help to access our resources through single sign-on. So you should not worry about the password reset and user management and multi-factor authentication. So all will be solved. So these features not available in other cloud providers. And if you want a migration task, you can easily single click. So just to click the migration tools, you can sync your on-prem to Azure. That would be very, very easy format here. So if you're going other cloud providers, you cannot get this option because I'm already worked with AWS, Oracle, and Azure. I mainly worked with Azure. So why I want to learn Azure? Azure opening increased due to COVID. As I said, the on-prem servers migration to Azure and the work from home started. So everybody work from home. So if you want to add new users, you can sync with on-prem and easy to provide the access management and accessibility and everything. And as of now, lots of migration projects are in queue. The one more thing is, see, if you go to any companies, lot of the organization having the 70 to 80% of Windows products. Very, very less companies they may have Linux or other non-Microsoft products. When the comparative come to migration projects, so you will give very less amount of money compared with AWS. And on one more choice, if you have already Windows license in on-prem, you can use that license to Azure. So they provide around 14% discount. So this will be provided by Azure only. And if you're going to take a SQL database, any Microsoft products, so when you're migrating, so that time cost is very less compared with other cloud service provider. And one more thing, companies are ready to offer best salary for cloud certified engineers rather than experience. You may have a 10 years of experience. If you don't have Azure or any cloud certification, this is difficult to get good salary. But even if you have a less experience, fresher, and you know the technology, this is the ticket for access your career with good salary. Course benefit. So which I'm providing course benefit here. See, Microsoft training material I'll be providing because I am certified a Microsoft certified professional, so I have direct access with Microsoft training material kit, so I can provide my training material from Microsoft website. And I'll teach you how to access the Microsoft free labs. So generally, if you want to access your labs, you have to provide your credit card. So if you use your credit card and you will use only 30 days. After 30 days, only limited resource you can able to access, and the other thing will chargeable. But I'll guide you how to access them and how to use them. What are the benefits? Even if you have a non-Microsoft login IDs, you can able to access. I'll provide that support. And monthly, I'll provide Azure updates and free webinars and peer links through Telegram groups. So that would be very helpful for you. And real-time experience, I'll share how I did and how to, what are the issues will come and how to tackle them and how to we do support with Microsoft and how to do this. So this training will be provided from my side. And also provide intuitive questions and how to tackle them, how to crack them. So So these are the main benefits from my side. The course duration for AZ-900 and 104. So AZ-900 of 15 days, and when you're going for AZ-104, 25 days. Most of them use AZ-104, AZ-900 basic, but when you taking AZ-104, that would be very useful for your career, because AZ-900, AZ-104, both the certification costs are same, like 4,800 plus tax. So if you learn AZ-104, that would be fine.